Hello everyone, welcome to the November Trade of the Month for SFO Magazine. I am Tim Kosen, my email address tim.kosen@gmail, my Twitter is KosenTrade, and I also keep a blog, kosentrade.wordpress.com, where I'll provide market commentary and observations, and also the occasional post about trading psychology, that type of thing. I'd like to thank you for joining us, and I'm going to assume hopefully that you've already read my fundamental defense of this trade, so we're going to look exclusively at the technicals in this session. So the trade again is long euro pound cross, and there's a bunch of reasons why I like this. We'll take a look here. We have the euro on the daily and the pound on the daily. We have the 200 moving average and the 100 moving average on both pairs, and also the Fib retracement here on both pairs as well. First reason why I like the pound weaker is we've already crossed the 100 under the 200 moving averages here, whereas we haven't done that yet on the euro. It looks like we're making a pretty good run for it, and we're probably going to get there, but we haven't made it yet. I do like both of these pairs, by the way, shorter at potentially higher periods. You can see that the pound is meeting more solid resistance on this Fib retracement and this previous support zone, support resistance area in here, than the euro is. We've already broken here. We have a pretty good bull candle on today's October 14th. So this might change by the time this comes out. But we have a pretty good bull candle here. So I do like both these shorter, potentially on these higher Fib retracements, these moving average congestion areas. But we have to get there first, and I think the pound is showing that it's the weaker currency. In addition, the RSI on the pound, this spike lower, I think, is also significant. It's quite a bit more momentum compared to these than the euro is. The euro, we have a lot more congestion, some indecision here, and while it does come lower here, not nearly as much. So that's it on the euro and the pound. Let's take a look then at the cross and take a look exactly at the trade. Now the first thing to notice is we have this potential bull flag forming, and we have a breakout of this area. We also have the 200 moving average here providing support and resistance as this play bounces around. And right now we have this this bull candle, which is showing that, you know, in my opinion, it wants to go up. Now we do have some wick action on the top and on the bottom, so we have to be cautious. But let's take a look at the trade. The trade, I said, I like this pair long above the 200 moving average, targeting potentially the Fib retracement here, and if this is a true bull flag, then potentially all the way up to the tops here. We'll see if it gets there. But as market conditions change, of course, you have to manage the trade and make sure the trade is something that you're comfortable with. And I like the stop, I think I said, about 45-50 pips below the moving average. And the reason for that is we'll take a look at these spikes, the recent spikes. This spike low here, the moving average comes in 86.63, and the price hits a low of 86.44. So what is that, just right around 20 pips. We do it again here, moving average 86.69. And the low is 86.54. So again, not a convincing break, but a pretty good bounce. It gives us enough breathing room. We have the same thing here on the longer side, a little bit longer spikes, where the low on this one, for instance, comes in at, let's see, 86.72, and the moving average 8700 or 8701. So a little bit more room, but not a whole lot. And that's how we play the stops. Now, play the stops, in my opinion, we'll see where this moving average ends up, maybe kind of in this direction, ends up as the trade progresses. So adjust your stops accordingly, and of course manage your risk accordingly. Now to the downside, if we do get a convincing break of this, we stand to potentially come back down into this flag, into this maybe potentially down channel. Look for a downside to the 50%, the 618 retracement. And the last reason why I do like this pair longer is the RSI down here has been well supported all the way down. It doesn't really break below this area, and we have broken above this trend line here, which is indicative of potential further advancement, and we're also now we're sitting just above the 50% line, which is, you know, potentially showing us that we want to go higher. So again, that's the trade of the month for SFO. Again, I'd like to thank you for joining us, and I look forward to your feedback. Have a great day.